Welcome back to my channel. If this is your first time watching, hi, I'm Hannah the Plus Size Hunter, and if you like this video, I hope that you'll subscribe. Today I'm talking all about base layers, why I think that they're the most important part of hunting, and what I love to use. So before I do that, I want to talk a little bit about how I personally have struggled quite a bit with base layers. I've tried really, I feel like everything. I've tried thermals, leggings, I've worn multiple pairs of pants, multiple jackets, multiple shirts, and all different, you know, materials. And I ran across this really great article in Adventurous Magazine by Jennifer Prudens. I hope I said that right. But it drew me in because the title was basically like, ah, why am I always cold? Which is exactly how I feel. I live and hunt in Texas and it can be 60 degrees and I feel cold. And the reason for that is because I know that that doesn't sound cold. And some people are probably like, ugh. But where I hunt, the wind is pretty strong typically. And so it's the wind for me personally that really affects me. Feeling the wind blow basically right through my clothes, just it makes me feel so cold, and it takes me forever also after the hunt is over to warm up. And so in this article, she talks about, I'll have the link in the description box down below, but she talks about a study that was done by the University of Maryland School of Medicine. And it's a study on the different people's body temperature. So everybody's body temperature is a little bit different, but they found that women have a higher body temperature than men, which means that if you step out into cold air, a woman is gonna feel a greater difference than what a man is gonna feel. So that's one thing. And then also, depending on where you're at in your cycle, or if you take hormonal birth control, that can also affect how cold you are. So you're not alone, I'm not alone, we're all cold. Let's try to talk about a way that I have found that helps me. And that's with a merino wool base layer. I have on one of the pieces that I will regularly wear. But before I show you exactly what I wear, I wanna talk a little bit about why merino wool is so great. So merino wool is great because it naturally wicks away sweat and dries really quickly. So you're not gonna be wearing a wet item, which can really make a big difference in making you feel cold, but it also doesn't hold on to a lot of odor. So people will wear this if they're hiking, backpacking, if they're gonna be wearing the same items over and over, which is also really great for hunting so that you don't have to buy a whole bunch of clothes. You can just, if you're gonna be hunting for a few days in a row, just, you know, stick it outside, let the air blow through it and it won't be super stinky. But I also want to talk a little bit about the fact that merino wool is going to be more of an investment, and that's why it took me a little bit longer to commit to a merino wool base layer, because it is more expensive. Merino wool is expensive. If you buy socks, which I have merino wool socks, tops and bottoms, and it is an investment, but they do last really long, and they, to me, they're worth it. I think that they're worth it. So I am gonna show you what I have. I will wear a short sleeve shirt during the lightweight season. And I have a short sleeve shirt, a long sleeve shirt, some legging type bottoms. And I'm wearing an XL in all of these. I got them from REI and I got them at the REI outlet. And I also used a coupon. So that kind of helped, you know, make the price a little bit better. And they'll regularly have these items on sale. But you can also just go on Amazon, which I did, and search for merino wool base layers and you'll find Woolex. I personally haven't tried those, but if you're looking for an option that maybe is a little more affordable, then that's definitely something that is out there for you. So typically I'll wear either a long sleeve or short sleeve shirt in the lightweight season because it does wick sweat away. And you can always take clothes off. You can't add clothes if you don't have them. So I'll wear that. And then once it starts getting a little colder in the mornings, I'll add on the pants. And once it gets even colder, I'll start pulling on more layers. So this is more of, for what I like to wear, this is much more of a heavier weight item, and it definitely does keep me very warm. So when I pair this with when I double layer my top and my bottom, and I pair it with my DSG Kylie bibs and jacket, I did that once and it was 32 degrees. I didn't have any issues. I felt very comfortable and didn't feel, I mean, I felt cool, but I did not feel cold. And so that's just something that I found. I think it's great. I know some people have an aversion to wool. Maybe you're allergic to wool and you can't wear wool. If that's the case, let me know in the comments down below what you've found that works for you, because I know I've gotten a couple comments from women saying that they cannot wear wool, or maybe you don't want to because you think it's itchy. But merino wool, in my opinion, once you wash it, like maybe you first put it on, you try it on in a dressing room or whatever, and it can feel a little itchy, but once you wash it, that itch really, in my opinion, goes away. So let me know what base layers you love. And we can all help each other out. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one.